My dear students, how are you? I think all of you are well and healthy and enjoy with parents in home. I request to all of you, please stay home and be safe during this corona crisis. Today I will discuss very important topics which is very important not only for your written examinations, it is very essential for your viva board and bedside discussion. Nobody can pass the final exam without these topics. So I request all of you and to enjoy this lecture, and if any questions, please write down in the comment box and I'll try to give you answer. Today our discussion about the congenital hemolytic anemia, that is thalassemia. Before discussion about the thalassemia, I want to tell about the some idea about the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin, what is hemoglobin? I think all of you know, hemoglobin is consist of heme plus globin. Heme plus globin. This globin is concerned for today class. This globin consists of polypeptide chain of amino acid. If this globin synthesis is deficient or absent, give rise to thalassemia. If abnormal globin synthesis, it give rise to hemoglobinopathy. I'll discuss it later. So hemoglobin consists of heme plus globin, and heme consists of iron plus protopyrrole ring. This iron is reused for RBC synthesis. This protopyrrole ring is involved in the metabolism of bilirubin. Now, what is the type of hemoglobin? There is three types of hemoglobin: embryonic hemoglobin, this is GAVR1, GAVR2, and fetal hemoglobin and adult hemoglobin. Adult hemoglobin two types, hemoglobin A and hemoglobin A2. So composition heme is heme plus globin chain. There are three types of hemoglobin: embryonic hemoglobin, GAVR1, GAVR2, portland, and fetal hemoglobin, hemoglobin F. It has high affinity to oxygen. And adult hemoglobin, two types, hemoglobin A, hemoglobin A2. You should know the sign of hemoglobin structure, that is alpha, beta, gamma and delta. In fetal hemoglobin, it consists of two alpha chain and two gamma chain. Two alpha chain and two gamma chain. And adult hemoglobin, hemoglobin A, 2 alpha and 2 beta, and hemoglobin A2, 2 alpha, 2 delta. If you look at the picture, this alpha 2 is constant in all hemoglobin, and change occurs in this portion, this is gamma, beta and delta. And there is alpha globin gene contains 4 gene. Alpha globin contains 4 gene, and gene located in the chromosome number 16. And beta globin gene contains 2 gene, which is located in the chromosome 11. It is asked in the viva board. So you should remember the alpha, beta, gamma and delta. This is the hemoglobin structure. This is hemoglobin, alpha globin, beta globin, alpha globin. That is adult hemoglobin, hemoglobin A, So 2 alpha 2 beta. Now this question asked in the Viva board, what are the causes of fetal hemoglobin? Increased fetal hemoglobin, causes of fetal increased fetal hemoglobin is hemolytic anemia, aplastic anemia, Fanconi anemia, leukemia, erythropoietin therapy. So what are the causes of increased fetal hemoglobin? These are the causes: hemolytic anemia, aplastic anemia, Fanconi anemia, leukemia, erythropoietin therapy. And A2, very important, A2 increased in normally less than 3.4%, but if increased more than 3.4%, the causes are thalassemia trait or carrier, megaloblastic anemia. And condition where decrease is iron deficiency anemia and alpha thalassemia. Sometimes it is asked in the Viva board. Now, appearance of hemoglobin. When appearance of hemoglobin, when hemoglobin appears, embryonic hemoglobin appears at the third month of gestation, and fetal hemoglobin appears at 8 week of gestation. At birth, it was near about 70%. This is fetal hemoglobin, this is adult hemoglobin, hemoglobin A, hemoglobin A2. This is intrauterine life, fetal hemoglobin dominant, and at birth it is 70%. And at 6 months, it reduced to less than 0.5%. And hemoglobin A, it is usually absent in intrauterine life. At birth it becomes 30%, and more than 6 months, when fetal hemoglobin replaced by adult hemoglobin, it becomes 97%. And hemoglobin A2, intrauterine life absent, at birth trace, and more than 6 months, it is 2.5%. So in adult, composition of hemoglobin is A more than 97%, A2 1.5 to 3.5%, and fetal hemoglobin trace or less than 1%. It is asked in Viva board. Normal hemoglobin constitutes in adult. Now I tell about something about the blood cell production. So it is the yolk sac, liver, spleen, bone marrow. Four things are involved in production of the RBC. In first trimester, yolk sac takes the role to producing RBC synthesis. In second trimester, liver and spleen and red bone marrow of the long bone and red bone marrow of the long bone. And after 18 years, on third trimester to 18 years, which give rise to RBC, it is red bone marrow of the long bone. And after 18 years, flat bone, sternum, rib, vertebra, and scalp and pelvis. So you should remember this picture, this yolk sac, liver, spleen, and bone marrow. So usually in first trimester, yolk sac, second trimester, liver, spleen, and red bone marrow of the long bone, and third trimester to 18 years of old, red bone marrow of the long bone. After 18 years, flat bone. Flat bone means sternum, rib, vertebra, scalp, and pelvis. And this first trimester yolk sac, first trimester liver, spleen, and red bone marrow of the long bone, and third trimester after 18 years of age, red bone marrow of the long bone. After 18 years, flat bone, that is sternum, ribs, vertebra, scalp, and pelvis. Sometimes it is asked in a Viva board. Now, what are the life of the RBC? Neonate, if baby is term 6 to 90 days, and preterm baby, it is only 35 to 50 days, and adult, it is 110 to 120 days. And bone marrow capacity to produce RBC, in acute hemolysis, bone marrow have 2 to 3 folds capacity to production of the RBC. And in long-standing hemolysis, it has capacity 6 to 8 folds. Sometimes it is asked in the bio board. Now, concentrated hemolytic anemia, that is, I will talk, today topic is thalassemia. Classification, I think all of you know, there is increased destruction, that is hemolytic anemia. Intracorpuscular causes, extracorpuscular causes. Intracorpuscular causes, there is a membrane defect, hereditary spherocytosis mainly, hereditary spherocytosis, and in hemoglobin, within hemoglobin, hemoglobinopathy, it is if it is globin, deficiency in globin synthesis, alpha or beta thalassemia, it's abnormal globin synthesis, sickle cell disease. Enzyme defect, this is G6PD deficiency, pyruvate kinase deficiency. Among these, today I will discuss about the beta thalassemia, that means thalassemia. Extracorpuscular causes, immunological cause and non-immunological cause, that is Coombe positive, Coombe negative. Sometimes in bio board, ask what are the, tell me some causes of Coombe positive hemolytic anemia. Isoimmune hemolytic anemia, that's a passively acquired antibody, such as hemolytic disease of the newborn, that is RS and AB incompatibility and incompatible blood transfusion. Another group is autoimmune hemolytic anemia, the actively formed antibodies. And non-immunological means Coombe negative hemolytic anemia, that is microangiopathic hemolytic anemia, DIC, hemolytic anemia syndrome, renal vein thrombosis, and septicemia, malaria, Wilson disease, drugs, and hypersplenism. Sometimes this is asked in the bio board. Now, today I will discuss about the intrinsic or intracorpuscular defect of RBC. That is deficient globin chain synthesis, thalassemia, alpha and beta. Structural abnormal globin synthesis, that is hemoglobin E disease, hemoglobin S disease, hemoglobin C disease. And membrane defect, hereditary spherocytosis, enzyme deficiency, G6PD deficiency. Now, inherited hemoglobin disorder, there are two groups. One is called structural hemoglobin variants such as sickle cell disease and deficient globin production, thalassemia. Now hemoglobinopathies. Structurally abnormal globin synthesis, hemoglobin E disease, hemoglobin S disease, hemoglobin C disease. This is the, that is qualitative defect in globin chain production. That is one amino acid in beta globin chain is replaced by the another amino acid. Very important, qualitative defect. Now, types of hemoglobinopathies. Hemoglobin E disease, S disease with sickle cell disease, and hemoglobin C disease. Look at the diagram. If this is the globin chain, if say in beta chain in 26 position, normally glycine present, if it is replaced by the lysine, so abnormal hemoglobin developed. So this is hemoglobinopathy, but structurally abnormal hemoglobin production. So this is qualitative, structural. And another one is quantitative, that is quantitative means there is beta chain, but number of beta chain, there is 2 beta chain, 3 beta chain, but 1 beta chain, if beta chain is synthesis reduced, is beta chain synthesis is reduced, it gives rise to thalassemia. But structurally, hemoglobin is normal. And sometimes, it's qualitative and quantitative, mixed type of hemoglobin they were developed, combined, this is hemoglobin E beta thalassemia. Now, general concept. The Thalassemia is derived from the Greek term. Thalassa means sea. Thalassa means sea. Emia means related to blood. It is discovered in the Mediterranean countries. In 1952, Cooley and Lee, two American scientists, named this anemia Cooley's anemia. Today, known as Thalassemia major or Mediterranean anemia. Now, incidence. In Bangladesh population, beta thalassemia rate 3%, hemoglobin E rate 4%, beta thalassemia or hemoglobin E beta thalassemia 33 per 10,000. Most prevalent in South Asia, Far East, the Middle East and Mediterranean countries. About 10 million people carry abnormal hemoglobin and about 7,000 babies are born every year with thalassemia. So day to day, the incidence of thalassemia is increasing in our country. Now definition, very important, asked in the Bhaiva board. It is heterogeneous group of inherited anemia, characterized by the reduced synthesis or absence of either alpha or beta globin chain of hemoglobin. So reduced synthesis or absence of either alpha or beta globin chain of hemoglobin. You know, adult hemoglobin consists of two alpha, two beta. If beta chain synthesis reduce, it gives rise to alpha thalassemia. If beta chain synthesis reduce, it gives rise to beta thalassemia. So there is structure in normal hemoglobin. Structure in normal hemoglobin, but reduced synthesis of alpha or beta chain give rise to congenital hemolytic anemia, that is thalassemia. Inheritance. Most common single gene disorder. It is not chromosomal disorder. It is genetic disorder which consists of single gene disorder. It is autosomal recessive. It is autosomal recessive. Beta thalassemia due to point mutation on the chromosome 11 and alpha thalassemia gene deletion on the chromosome 16. So look at this term, the autosomal recessive, very important, and it is a single gene disorder, not chromosomal disorder, that is Mendelian disorder. Guys, look at the picture. Sometimes this picture is given in exam in the OSPI board or Bhaiva board, OSPI exam or Bhaiva board. There's family, the four brother sisters, they're paired to thigh, distal abdomen due to hepatosplenomegaly, the facial changes. So there is family history of same disease. So it is called the autosomal recessive disorder. And if you ask the question, you diagnosis possibly congenital hemolytic anemia, possibly thalassemia. Now classification, very important. Now thalassemia symptom classified at the genotypic classification, phenotypic classification, and depends on blood transfusion. Now genotypic classification, alpha thalassemia, alpha globin chain contains 4 gene. Normal 2 alpha normal. And if one gene deleted out of 4, so 2 normal, one gene is deleted, silent carrier. If 2 genes are deleted, 2 are normal, alpha thalassemia trait. If 3 genes are deleted, 1 gene are normal, hemoglobin H disease. If 4 genes are deleted, which is lethal, it is called a hemoglobin burst, or hydrospitalis. So these are genotypic classification. Genotypic classification. Now classification of the beta thalassemia. Genotype contain thalassemia beta globin chain contain two gene. This is one gene. It is one gene. Normally, normal BB. Normal is BB. If one gene is synthesis reduced, that is, it is normal. It is reduced synthesis. It is normal. It is one gene is absent. Complete synthesis reduced. Silent carrier, that is thalassemia minor or state. If both gene are reduced, or one gene is reduced, one gene is absent, moderate. And if both gene are absent, both gene are absent, it gives us the beta thalassemia major, severe presentations. So in beta thalassemia major, the genotype is B0. B0 means absence of beta globin chain. Now phenotypic classification. In beta thalassemia major, the severe hemoglobin E beta thalassemia, and beta thalassemia intermedia, milder hemoglobin E beta thalassemia, and beta thalassemia minor, which is also called a trait or carrier. In our country, this hemoglobin E beta thalassemia is more common, which is asked in Viva Board, whose thalassemia is common in our country? Hemoglobin E beta thalassemia is more common in our country. Now, alpha thalassemia classification, silent alpha thalassemia carrier, or alpha thalassemia trait or minor, hemoglobin H disease, hemoglobin BARDS or hydrospitalis. Now, difference of blood transfusion, again thalassemia syndrome classified into transfusion dependent thalassemia and transfusion non-dependent thalassemia. The beta thalassemia major, severe hemoglobin E beta thalassemia, transfusion dependent hemoglobin H disease, and surviving hemoglobin BARDS hydrops. And non-transfusion dependent thalassemia, mild or moderate hemoglobin E beta thalassemia or alpha thalassemia intermedia, that is called hemoglobin H disease, hemoglobin E disease, beta thalassemia trait, hemoglobin E trait, alpha thalassemia carrier. Now very important topics is beta thalassemia, very common in our country. Pathogenesis, reduced synthesis or absence of beta chain. 2-alpha in adult hemoglobin, adult 2-alpha and 2-beta. So if beta thalassemia, if beta chain synthesis reduced or absent due to mutation of the beta globin gene of the chromosome 11, give rise to beta thalassemia. Now beta thalassemia major basic concept, absent beta chain. Definitely absent beta chain, 2 beta absent, so only alpha, and it is homozygous, that means 2 beta chain all are synthesis is absent. Genotype B0, so no beta chain synthesis. Basic pathophysiology is imbalance between alpha globin chain and beta globin chain. Look at the picture. In beta chain synthesis absent, but alpha chain synthesis continue at normal rate. So there is imbalance between 2 alpha chain and beta chain. Very important. This is the pathophysiology. The reduced level of beta globin synthesis, absent beta globin chain, absence of reduced or absence of beta globin chain, it gives rise to excess P alpha globin chain. So there's 2 alpha, 2 beta. The beta chain synthesis reduced or absent. So alpha chain continues production of alpha chain at normal rate. So there is excess alpha globin chain production and give rise to two things. This alpha globin chain, it is when excess, it precipitate in the RBC and it produces damage to the RBC membrane and cause producing hemolysis in the spleen. That is peripheral hemolysis, which give rise to anemia. And another important, and the main cause of pathophysiology of the thalassemia, and when absence of beta globin chain, precipitation in the erythroid precursor within the bone marrow. That means excess alpha chain, which is precipitated in the erythroid precursor in the bone marrow. And premature death of the erythroid precursor, it is called the ineffective erythropoiesis. So premature destruction of the RBC within the bone marrow, which is called the ineffective erythropoiesis. Very important. It's a very important pathophysiology of the beta thalassemia. And both these effects develop anemia. When anemia develops, what happens? It increases erythropoietin synthesis. When erythropoietin synthesis increases, there is tremendous amount of RBC production and give rise to bone marrow expansion and skeletal changes. When bone marrow expansion, it gives pressure to the skeleton and cortical thinning, skeletal changes, and also there is hypermetabolic stage. And another is anemia, it increases the iron absorption and give rise to iron overload. And iron overload not only from this mechanism, it also develop from the blood transfusion, and due to iron overload, ultimately pathology affected cardiac death. And another consequence of anemia is when bone marrow capacity is exhausted, bone marrow capacity exhausted to produce RBC, so RBC production occurs in the extramedullary side, that is spleen, liver, and give rise to hepatosplenomegaly. So this is the consequence of anemia, very important. Now hemoglobin increase fetal hemoglobin. Fetal hemoglobin is 2 alpha 2 gamma production. Alpha chain combined with gamma chain resulting in fetal hemoglobin being the dominant hemoglobin. So it is the main pathogenesis of the why fetal hemoglobin is more in the beta thalassemia. This is because alpha chain combined with more alpha chain combined in the gamma chain producing fetal hemoglobin and being the dominant hemoglobin. Now hallmark of beta thalassemia, very important, the ineffective erythropoiesis, compensatory massive bone marrow expansion, erythroid hyperplasia of the bone marrow. So ineffective erythropoiesis means premature destruction of the RBC within the bone marrow. So when there is anemia, give rise to anemia, the erythropoietin increase, give rise to tremendous production of the RBC, and which results in massive bone marrow expansion and as well as erythroid hyperplasia of the bone marrow. The effects of marrow expansion. What are the effects of marrow expansion? There is pathological flexure. Why pathological flexure? Because it produces cortical thinning, sinus, deformity of skull and face due to marrow expansion. There is sinus and middle ear infection due to ineffective drainage, and also there is hypermetabolic state because due to tremendous production of RBC and give rise to fever, wasting, and also give rise to iron absorption from the GI tract and give rise to iron overload. Now, causes of stunted growth, very important, which is asked in Bhagavad. Stunted growth. You think, what are the causes of stunted growth? Number one is chronic anemia, which occurs in the thalassemia. Number two is zinc deficiency. Number three is undernutrition. Number four is hypercholesterolemia. Number five is folate deficiency. Number six is chronic liver disease. Number four, endocrinopathy, especially in the hyperpituitarism, hypothyroidism, and also the psychological stress. So this is chronic anemia, zinc deficiency, undernutrition, hypersplenism, folate deficiency, chronic liver disease, endocrine factors, hypopituitarism, hypothyroidism, psychosocial stress. Chronic anemia due to chronic hemolysis gives rise to growth failure. Also, there is zinc deficiency occurs due to less intake. This zinc deficiency gives rise to growth failure, and undernutrition also leads to growth failure. There is hypersplenism due to excessive detection of the RBC in the spleen. Folate deficiency, there is folate deficiency give rise to anemia, this megaloblastic anemia, and if not supplied during the supply in case of thalassemia. In chronic liver disease, usually due to chronic iron overload, that is hemosiderosis, give rise to chronic liver disease. Sometimes it may develop due to transfusion related hepatitis B virus, C virus infection, and some endocrine factors, that is if iron load occurs in the pituitary gland, give rise to hyperpituitarism, and if it is deposited in the thyroid gland, and give rise to hypothyroidism. And also the psychosocial stressful condition, there is less intake of food, give rise to growth failure. Now, causes of hepatomegaly, very important. Why causes hepatomegaly occurs in the thalassemia? Because there is extramedullary erythropoiesis, number one. Due to extramedullary erythropoiesis, number one. Number two, due to iron overload, that is hemosiderosis. Number three, patient may sometimes develop a chronic liver disease and chronic active hepatitis, may be transmission related, that is hepatitis B virus, C virus infection. This is extramedullary erythropoiesis, number one cause. Number two is iron overload, that is hemosiderosis. Number three, hemochromatosis. Number three is chronic liver disease and chronic active hepatitis due to transfusion-related infection, what is B, C, and HIV. Now, causes of splenomegaly. It is also due to the extramedullary erythropoiesis. Number one, that is due to hypersplenism. What do you mean by hypersplenism? Hypersplenism means the moderate to gross splenomegaly. There is bicyclopenia, monocytopenia or pancytopenia. There is change in the bone marrow, and with splenectomy, the bone marrow change becomes normal. And work hypertrophy due to constant hemolysis. Also, there is cause of the constant hemolysis occurring in the spleen. There is extramedullary hematopoiesis, hypersplenism, progressive splenomegaly, work hypertrophy due to constant hemolysis. Now, causes of jaundice. Usually, jaundice was found in the thalassemia. Why? Because liver has capacity to handle the bilirubin. Bilirubin, you know, 6 to 8 times. When this threshold level cross, patient develops jaundice. So what is the cause of jaundice? Number one, hemolysis. There is constant chronic hemolysis occurs, give rise to unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia. There is transfusion related hepatitis, or there may be due to iron overload, hematochromosis or hemosiderosis. There is also the gallbladder stone formation, give rise to obstructive jaundice. Also, sometimes patients develop cholangitis. So these causes are give rise to jaundice in the thalassemic patients. Infection is common in the thalassemia, intercurrent infection. What are the causes of infection? Number one, poor nutrition, increase iron in the body. You know, iron is the main diet of bacteria, and iron helps in the multiplication of the bacteria. So increase iron, increase susceptibility infection. Blockage of monocyte macrophage system, hyperinsulinism, give less leukopenia, infection associated with transmission. So all things producing infections. Effects of iron overload, very important endocrinopathy. When iron deposits in the pituitary gland, there is pituitary damage. So give rise to hyperpituitarism. Due to hyperpituitarism, patient develops short stature, delayed puberty, poor sexual maturation. And when is deposited in the islets of Langerhans, beta cell damage, give rise to diabetes mellitus and diabetic ketoacidosis. So if a thalassemia patient comes with you with hyperventilation, you think patient develop diabetic ketoacidosis until otherwise. And in thalassemia patient, sometimes patient may come with you polyuria, polyphagia, polydipsia, and leg ulcer. And in that case, you think patient suffering from diabetes mellitus due to iron overload, iron deposit in the beta cells. Adrenal deficiency when iron overload occurs in the adrenal gland, give rise to adrenal damage and producing adrenal insufficiency, which may be lead to acute adrenal crisis and give rise to shock. Sometimes chronic adrenal insufficiency, in that case you get the hyperpigmentation. And acquired hypothyroidism give rise to cold intolerance, constipation, and sometimes patient develop hypothyroidism, give rise to tetany. Now, effects of iron overload, deposition the liver. When deposition the liver, it gives rise to cirrhosis of the liver. When deposition in the heart, it gives rise to cardiomyopathy, cardiac failure, and sterile pericarditis. When deposition in the lungs, restrictive lung disease, and also lead to the infection. Now, complication. Most important complication is growth failure, intercurrent infection, which is caused by the fever, heart failure, cause of heart failure in thalassemia, there is two to three causes, that is anemic heart failure, number one. Number two is due to cardiac, due to iron overload in the heart, give rise to heart failure. And serious changes, bony changes, fracture and osteoporosis give rise to leg pain. Why fracture and osteoporosis? Because there is cortical thinning, and cortical thinning due to extramedullary expansion, and also there is iron depletion give rise to fracture. The hyperinsulinism is clinically, it is evidenced by the moderate to huge splenomegaly and bleeding manifestation such as PTG, purpura, ecchymosis, or bleeding from the nose, gum. But sometimes patient may be develop pressure symptoms due to marrow expansion and the hypersplenism and huge splenomegaly in the abdomen give rise to pressure symptoms. Why there is paraplegia? Paraplegia occurs due to it is manifested by the weakness of lower limb due to extramedullary atrophy in the vertebral canal, which give rise to pressure in the spinal nerve, and patient develop paraplegia. In that case, you may get the weakness of lower limb. So if a thalassemic patient present with a weakness of lower limb, you think patient develop paraplegia and it is acute medical emergency. In that case, it should need the radiotherapy, otherwise this pressure symptom does not relieve. Now, abdominal discomfort and pain due to huge splenomegaly would give the pressure, and patient develop abdominal discomfort and pain. Now, complication due to iron overload. Iron overload is first in the liver and give rise to liver failure, cirrhosis, and second organ is the endocrine system, and third one is heart. Now, other complications: gallstone formation, aplastic caries, uric acid nephropathy, and thrombophilia. very important is aplastic crisis. Now, causes of death: the heart failure, intercurrent infection, diabetic ketoacidosis, liver cirrhosis, that is liver cell failure. Now, diagnosis. Diagnosis: there's history, physical examination and investigation. Diagnosis depends on the history, physical examination and investigation. Now, history: the age of presentation, usually within 2 years of age, earlier 6 to 9 months of age, because in this age, fetal hemoglobin is replaced by the fetal hemoglobin, and rare less than 3 months of age. So, usually presentation within 2 years of age, and rare below 3 months of age. Symptom: presenting complaints, there's pallor. Pallor is gradual pallor, weakness, lethargy. Sometimes in Bible board, asked in the what are the causes of rapidly progressive pallor. Rapidly progressive pallor causes two causes, leukemia and aplastic anemia. But in thalassemia, there is gradual pallor. And pallor means anemia. Anemia is the laboratory diagnosis, pallor is the clinical sign or symptom. Failure to thrive, yellowish coloration of the eye and urine, that is jaundice. There are bony changes, facial changes, repeated infection. Usually, these are the main presentation of the thalassemic patient. Now, present with symptoms of complications, such as abdominal pain due to partial symptom, respiratory distress made due to the heart failure, and patient may develop the polyuria, polypasia, polydipsia, leg ulcer due to the diabetes mellitus. Sometimes patient develop hyperpigmentation due to diabetic ketoacidosis, bleeding from the nose and gum due to hypersplenism, weakness of the lower limb due to the pressure on the spinal cord due to extramedullary erythropoiesis, swelling of the body. And why swelling of the body? If patient develop heart failure and cold intolerance due to acquired hypothyroidism, sometimes patient develop pain in the limb due to osteoporosis due to iron overload. And also you should take the history of risk factors, family history, very important, consanguinity of parents, very important, and you should take the history of affected parents or sibling, very important, and which is asked in the Viva board. And you should take the treatment history, blood transfusion, selection, surgery, splenectomy. Now, signs, physical examination, general examination, appearance, tell me what is the appearance, is it normal or ill looking? In thalassemic patients, in early stage may be normal, but in late stage becomes ill. And there is special dysmorphism, which is called the hemolytic phase or sheep mung phase. So in special dysmorphism, it is hemolytic phase or sheep mung phase, pallor moderate to severe, jaundice may or may not be present, and broadened and thickened hand, and skin survey, very important. In skin survey, complexion, there is grayish complexion due to the pallor, jaundice and hemosiderosis. There is three things occurs: pallor, jaundice and hemosiderosis, and give rise to skin color changes, is grayish brown complexion. And also you may get the hyperpigmentation of the creases of the palm and tongue due to a development of Addison disease. And you also get the leg ulcer. Sometimes you get the petechiae purpura ecchymosis due to hypersplenism. And you may get the evidence of heart failure due to anemic heart failure. And in that case, you may get the edema and also the raised jugular venous pressure. And if you do the puberty staging sexual menstruation rate, in that case there are delayed puberty. Vital signs usually stable unless heart failure. Anthrometry, of course, there is growth failure. This is the simpang pace or hemolytic pace. There is frontal bushing, parietal bushing, malar prominence, depressed nasal bone, and malocclusion of the teeth, and upward protruded lip, and upward protruded lip. This give rise to hemolytic pace or simpang pace. You should not tell the mongoloid pace. Mongoloid pace only present in the Down syndrome. System examination. Abdomen, hepatomegaly, moderate to gross, enlarged hepatomegaly, it is non-tender. If you get the tender hepatomegaly, in that case, you may think patient develop heart failure. Splenomegaly, moderate to gross, gross splenomegaly. Hepatomegaly, splenomegaly, that is moderate to gross hepatomegaly. And this sometimes this picture is given in the OSPI, and this is the distant abdomen. There is a hugely enlarged spleen, and also there may be hepatomegaly. And other systems to exclude the complication, not for diagnosis success, for CBS examination, evidence of heart failure, respiratory system evidence of heart failure, such as bilateral crepitation, and CNS, evidence of paraplegia, the muscle tone increase, power reflex power also the reduce, and deep retinal reflex are exaggerated, gait is maybe limping gait or impaired walking, that may sensation may be diminished. And DD, very most important DD of thalassemia is the other causes of congenital hemolytic anemia. Now congenital histiocytosis, hemoglobin E disease, sickle cell anemia, colors of malaria. There are three headings. If you ask the bio board, what are the causes of DD of the thalassemia, you tell the other congenital hemolytic anemia, such as congenital histiocytosis, hemoglobin E disease, sickle cell anemia, colors of and malaria. If you think, if you ask the what type of malaria, you tell the tropical splenomegaly syndrome. Most common congenital hemolytic anemia. You ask the which one is more common in our country. Your answer is most common common thalassemia in our country is the E beta thalassemia. Now investigation. Again, investigation divided into routine investigation, specimen investigation, investigation for complication, and investigation for treatment. Dear student, I think next portion of the thalassemia I discuss in next classes. Thank you for enjoying the class. Thanks.